Hi everyone, welcome you all. In my previous video, I have shown you how we can send GET request and how we get the response and how we can validate the API we have seen. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how we can send POST request and then how we can verify the response. Now first of all, we need to understand the POST request means it will create a new resource in the web server. And for that, we need to send request along with the body. And also we need to specify the content type, means we need to have a URL and what type of content we are sending, and that's called content type. And also we require body, so what kind of data we are sending along with this URL. So after that, we do certain validations on status code and response body, whether this record is created in the database properly or not, we can verify. Now let me show you how we can do this. And before directly jump into PyCharm, I will show you how we can test this API in Postman, and then I'll try to automate the same API. So first of all, let's go to Postman tool. Now I'm sending the same request and taking the new request, and here I'm sending post request, specify this URL. And for this URL, we need to also send body for that. Now click on this body, and the body is in JSON format. So I'm just taking raw, and here I'll say JSON format of data, and that data we need to specify. So for example, I have some sample data, so which contains first name, last name, username, password, email, and this data should be unique. So next time we need to again change the data. So once you send this data along with this post request, then it will go and create a new record in the database. Now let me send it. Now once you have sent, so it is saying like user already exists. That means I already created some user with the same name. And let me just change the username. Let's say XYZ. Now click on the send. Now it is created a new user. So what is the output we are getting here is status code is 201 and success code is operation success and message is operation completed successfully. Now through automation, we are going to send the same kind of request with the data, and also we are going to verify the message which is displayed on the response and also status code. Now let's start PyCharm. Now in the PyCharm, I already created API automation project, and under test cases, I am creating a new test case. Go to the new and take another file. You can take a robot file or you can just take a normal file and robot file. And if you need to give some name of the file, so let me just give TC underscore post underscore request. Right, so take this and it will create new robot file. So TC underscore post underscore request. So by default, it is given some structure and we don't require all these things. We can just remove for this. Even keywords also I don't need. Settings, I need a variable section. I'm also creating a variables and test case. So let me just start setting section. Here we need to refer library, request library. So I'll just say library, and my library name is request library, request library I need to refer. And apart from this, we need to also refer one more library. This is basically request library. All right, so next one is I need to also refer one more library called collections library, because here we have some data. So this particular data I will maintain in the dictionary object in Python. So for that, we need one more collection called one more library called collections library. So library, I'll say collections. All right, so now once we specify required libraries and come to the variable part, and here I will define one variable with base URL. So I'll just create one simple variable. I will name it as base underscore URL. And the value of this URL is, I'm just specifying the URL of my API request. And relative URL, whatever I'm saying here, this I will pass as part of post request. Now come to this test cases section. Here we need to give some title. So here I will say put underscore customer registration. I'm just giving some name to this. This is my test case. Now the first thing is we need to create a session by using this particular base URL. So how to create a session? So create session and give some name to our session. Let's say I say my session, and then we need to specify the URL of the API. So with this URL, I'm establishing the session. Now with this using by session, I need to send a request. So now we need to send a post request. So I am writing a keyword called post request. And what are all things we require to send a post request? So we need to pass this session. And along with this, we need to also specify the relative URL. So my relative URL is /register is my relative URL. So that I need to pass /register is my relative URL. And then we need to also specify, and we need to give one tab space, register, and we need to also specify the data as well as content type. So to specify the data and content type, before sending the post request, I will create two different dictionary objects or different dictionary variables. And one variable contains the data, the other variable contains the type of data. So here I will create two variables. I'll just say dollar and body. Right, so body is equal to, so I'm just going to create a new dictionary object. So to create a new dictionary object, we have a keyword called create dictionary. And if you want to work with these keywords, we need to import collections library. Now create dictionary, and here we have to add all the stuff. So whatever the data we are passing here, this particular data we need to pass. So how to add values to the dictionary? So if you want to add values to the dictionary and just pass values like this. So the first value is a first name. Second one is last name, username, password, email. So first name I'm passing here. Let me just have some data here. And what I can do is, yes, I'll just have some data. I'm just putting it over here. Remove this. And whenever you're putting the data, make sure you have to give three spaces. Create a dictionary. And here create a dictionary, right? So body equal to create dictionary, and here give one tab space, and first name is equal to Raj1234, and give one more three spaces, last name, username, and value. So here basically dictionary contains a key and a value. You can call it as a key value pair. So this is a key and value, this is another key and value, and also password and email. So this is the data currently we have added to this dictionary object, that is called body. And similarly, and this particular body we have to send here. And now in the post request, by using this session, I am sending /register relevant URL along with the body. And also we need to specify what kind of body it is, what content we are sending, the format of the content also we need to specify. So the format of the content is, I can store content inside one variable, and here I will say header. Okay, so we need to also pass, because content type is a one of the header, we can also add multiple headers. So content type is a mandatory header when you do the post request. So header is equal to, so here also I will create one more dictionary, because the content type means it is also having key and value. Content type is a key, value is JSON/application. Now create a dictionary, and here I have a variable called content type, content-type. So this is basically header. So once you send the post request, along with the post request, we need to send body, and also we need to specify what kind of format it is. So that format is representing by content type. So content type is equal to, and the content type is application/JSON. So another dictionary I created. So one dictionary variable contains the data, and another dictionary variable header contains the type of data, content type application/JSON. Now the post request, we need to send multiple things. We need to specify the name of the session, which you are open here, and relative URL. So this URL will go and create a new record in the database. And with this body and whatever data we mentioned here, with the same data, it will go and create a record. And also we need to specify the header. So if you want to pass a header, and we cannot pass body like this directly, we have to add one more keyword called data is equal to body. So my session, and this is my relative URL, and then data is equal to this data I'm going to send. And here we need to have one more keyword called headers. headers is equal to, if you want to pass headers along with this body by using headers keyword, we need to say. So here we already have one header, which is content type I'm specifying here. So this is the whole statements. So these are the two dictionaries I have created. So body, header, and the response. Body, header, and the response. So let me just align properly. So this is body and header, response, sorry, a body I have modified. Let me just add this body properly. Okay, so this is the body. And indentation is very important. And if you something went wrong in the indentation, your script will fail. Okay, all right. So now we have a body and header which is representing content type. And along with the post request, I'm using session and register is a relative URL. And this is the data I'm passing. And this is the header I'm passing. And whatever the response I'm getting, I'm stored that into some other variable, response variable. All right. Now let us print the response also here. I will say log to console and I am printing the response status code I'm going to print. So how to print response dot status code, status underscore code. So this will give you the status code which is written by this statement. And because this is a post request, if any record is newly created, it will send 201 as a status code. And I will also print the response, what exactly it is created record or not. The confirmation message also I'm going to print from the log to console. From the same response, I'm also going to print the content dot content. All right, so I have opened my session and I have added the data inside this body dictionary variable. Now I create one more dictionary variable which contains a one more value which is representing header, because whenever you send a post request, we must specify the body and also type of the body. That means it's JSON format. So currently this data is JSON format and this API is accepting JSON format of input. So I'm saying that as application slash JSON. And also I'm getting the response here from the post request, and then I'm printing the status code and content type. Now we can also do some validations here. Let me also write directly validations. So validations are, we can verify the status code and we can verify the content message. So for example, under validations, I'll say I'm getting the content, right? So this will give you the content of the response. So I'm just putting it here and I want to store this content in some variable. So here I will just create one more variable. I will also name it as a body and say response underscore body. And equal to, and here by default will give you JSON format. So I will convert that into string format. So for that we have a method called convert. The method is convert to string. So we have to use convert to string and then specify the dollar response content. Now this response content in JSON format will be converted into string format and then stored in this variable. Response res underscore body. Now in this particular body, I am verifying. So if you just go and see the postman tool, these are the two messages we got in the response. So I'm going to verify this. So now I have to use a verification point. Let's say should contain, right? Should contain, and this variable should contain this one, operation success. I am verifying this message. I'm expecting this message should be there inside this variable. Means which contains a response message. And apart from this, I will also try to verify another message, operation completed successfully. That also I'm verifying and put it here. So in the same response body, we have two messages. One is operation successful, operation completed successfully. Right, so this will give you a response. And we can also verify a status code if you need. If I want to verify the status code, again, we have to do the same thing. So take this status code. This is verification body and status code I can store in some variable. So here I will say status underscore code equal to, and this is a variable and I can store this status code. So whatever status code I'm capturing from the response, I'm storing that into status code variable. And then, and this is again in the number format. We have to convert that into string. So again, we have to use convert to string, and the status code will be converted into the string, then store into that variable. So here again, we can use one more keyword called should be equal, and the status code, and what's our expected should be 201. Right, so 201 I'm expecting. Right, so this is a validation. So we have verified status code, and also we are verified message, whatever the response message, right? Now this is our test case, guys. So let me repeat once again. So here mentioned the variable, this is a base URL, and we open the session, we create a new session with the base URL. Now we need to send body along with the post request. So for that I have created one dictionary variable, and which contains all the data. Also we need to specify the content type whenever we specify the body. So for that also I create one more dictionary object where I specify the content type is equal to application/json. Now I'm sending the post request with my session name and relative URL, data along with the header. And after that we got the response in this variable. Now I'm printing status code here, printing the content here, and then I do some validations on the status code. I capture the status code, convert that into string, and put that into some other variable. Now here I'm comparing this actual status code with our expected status code. Now again I'm capturing the whole content into this variable response body, and I'm verifying this response body contains operation success message and also operation completed successfully message. So this is a whole test case. Let's execute now. So go to terminal, and here just type robot, and test case is my directory. Inside this my test case is tc_post_request.robot. Let me just rename it, and I will say tc2 post_request.robot. Click on the refactor. Now it is renamed. Now I can run the test case. Let's say tc2_post_request.robot. Let's execute now. So now I have executed my test case. Now it is getting failed. Right, so now we'll see why it is getting failed. So here we have properly sent a request, right? And also we have sent body, and also here if you just go to the post request and specify the session name, relative URL, data and header, right? So here the problem is, when you send the post request, I have given some mistake here. This is my session, right? So I need to use same my session variable. So here a small mistake. Let's execute one more time and clear the buffer. And then we'll try to execute. All right, so now again, it is getting failed. Now this time, what is saying? It is giving 200 is a status code, but what you are expecting 201. But it is getting failed. Why it is getting failed again? Because it is saying user already exists. So that means whatever data we are passing here with this data username, the already user is exist. So that's the reason it's giving 200 status code, and our test case is also failed. So let me change this username 1234 else XYZ. Save it. Now let me execute one more time. Right. So again, it is getting failed. And it is saying again this user is already exist. Now let me change the first name, last name also. Let's say something called, I'm adding something else, XYZ. I'll say ABC, and I'm just changing the username, and also email I have modified, and password also I modified. And if you have the same data in the database, it will say user already existing. Okay, let me run one more time. Clear the buffer. Right, so one more time again, it's saying user already existed. I think even these users are already there. Okay, let me just change the user. I will give something different. Let me just remove this. Right, so now I have just given some other data. Create dictionary, first name Kiran1234, Kiran1234 I have given. Right, so let's see how it is going to work. So username Kiran1234, I'll say XYZ. Close, clear buffer, and then execute. All right, so now we can see my test case is got passed, and also we can see 201 is a status code, right? 201 is a status code, and also it is printing the content here. We logged into status code and also we logged content, right? So this is status code, operation successful, operation completed successfully, and both the validation points also passed. Okay, so this is how, and we need to verify the post request. And here I have just taken small data, and sometimes we may have complex data. Okay, so but if you have a complex data like this, how we can handle that, I will cover in the next coming videos. So here I'm just taking a small set of data and store that data inside the body dictionary, and in the dictionary object I'm passing the same data to the along with the post request. Okay, and as soon as we get some response, I can verify the status code and also message. So this is how we can send post request to the REST API. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.